Liz Jacobs here with you for Kalkine Media. Today we're exploring dual ion batteries and how they work. Before we do jump in, make sure you hit that bell icon at the bottom of your screen for all the latest updates. Since the world is undergoing a rapid transition to electric mobility, batteries will play an important role in facilitating this shift. The growing popularity of EVs could be attributed to various factors, including advancements in battery technology. EV can cover more ground in a single charge and generate enough power for a smooth and quick run. Research work is underway to develop more efficient battery technologies with different electrolyte and electrode combinations. On this front, one of the emerging and highly interesting research fields is the dual ion battery. The dual ion battery is a high voltage energy storage system. A dual ion battery, or DIB, functions on a mechanism with positively charged ions and negatively charged ions stored separately in the anode and cathode during the charging and discharging process. In dual ion batteries, the cations and anions are active and move in parallel from the electrolyte to anode and cathode, respectively. DIBs hold the potential for large-scale stationary storage of electricity. A battery has three parts: a positive electrode called cathode, a negative electrode called the anode, and an electrolyte. The positive charged ions, or cations, from the cathode flow towards anode. When this action happens in a loop, electricity is generated due to the motion of the charge. This is the basic difference between normal lithium-ion and dual-ion batteries. So to recap, in DIBs, both the charges move parallel to each other, towards their respective electrodes. As both the ions in the electrolyte are active, further optimization of the battery is achieved. The research on DIBs is still in its initial stage. The prime objective of the research work is to develop a stationary storage facility that is low in cost and doesn't involve metals like lithium, nickel, and cobalt. Currently, performance-wise, DIBs have only one-third capacity compared to Li-ion batteries, or Li-ion batteries possessing one of the highest energy densities. Thus, lithium batteries can provide significant energy, and still, their sizes can remain smaller. The mechanism used in DIBs makes them suitable for high-power applications using moderately high energy. This makes them suitable for grid energy storage applications. The size of the battery may not fit in mobile or other gadgets, but could be put to use in a local utility system. So watch this space, and that's a wrap for now. But please check out the website for more, kalkinemedia.com, and make sure you like, comment, and subscribe to the channel. I'm Rose Jacobs. Thanks again for joining me.